I'm a bit controversial in this respect because I'm not really into the comic book superhero films. Sorry, guys. It's just not my. I love being part of it. I completely get it. But I'm actually clueless as to what's coming out apart from Civil War because I went and gate crashed the set about three times in Atlanta. What I'm most looking forward to is seeing his kind of smesh stomach. Just make sure he was still there. I'm most looking forward to seeing kind of the development of Chris's characterization. I think he's just gotten better with every cap role he's played in the films. And I think they get darker, they get more psychologically interesting. We'll see. He wouldn't even tell me the story of what happens. So I wasn't even allowed that, but something. Peggy's kind of in there somewhere.
Okay.
Hi, Hayley.
Hello.
I know, like Borden said, we all love your Dubsmash videos, and you said you're really humbled by us dressed like Peggy Bondot. How threatened were you, though, by Clark Gregg impersonating Peggy?
What, when he dressed up as Peggy? You mean?
Yeah.
Well, I was quite tired, and so I went to bed early, so I just kind of ordered room service and sat in my room as James went downstairs to with all the team of S.H.I.E.L.D. to get ready to go to this big Entertainment Weekly party that I decided to opt out of. And he kept texting me and going, they're all going crazy behind this curtain, overexcited and really proud of themselves and what they're doing. And I was like, it's gonna be fine, guy. You know, James, we've nailed it, we're fine. I'm just gonna have my chicken Caesar salad and go to bed. And then James texted me and went, oh shit. Sorry to swear, children. It's bad. Watch your language. So I was like, oh, it can't be that bad. But then the exciting thing was is that S.H.I.E.L.D. were trying to upload it on Instagram and on Twitter, but for some reason the internet was down, and they thought for about a good 20 minutes they'd actually lost the video. But James was sat in the van with them all going to this party as I'm sat there going, show them, I just want to see it. And they were losing their minds because they were that close to not having got it. And then just as they pulled up at the party, Clark found it again. Went, oh my God, oh my God, I've got it, posted it. And I watched it and I was livid. I was so upset with how good it was. I was disgusted. And that was why then I was just like, well, this is the saddest day of my life. And then James and I, we obviously, neither of us had slept properly because we turned up the next morning, both of us had bags under each other's our eyes. And James just goes, there's only one way to win this. I was like, tell me. And he goes, it means a lot of money, a lot of time, and a lot of travel. I said, I'm in. I don't care what it costs. I'm in. And he went, we need to go to Atlanta. We need to get Chris. And I was like, yeah! So I called up Chris immediately and he was like, what? I was like, okay, so we're gonna get up at 3:30 in the morning, come to Atlanta for a 9-second dance smash, and then we'll fly straight back, so we won't interfere with you, we know you're filming on set, you just need to be in your cap and we need your S.H.I.E.L.D. And he's like, oh. And then can we have a snog afterwards? We need to visit you. And he's like, oh yeah, that's fine. Such serious business.
Seriously.